Good morning, everyone. Andrew Bullock from Big T's Fitness. Do you want to know how to do an excellent warm-up to get every single joint good and warmed up before you do a workout? This will decrease on your injuries that you can sustain, and it will also boost all the other muscle recruitment that you can get. Let's get into the video. All right, to do a proper warm-up, we're going to be starting with the wrists, go to the elbows, go to the shoulders, go to the torso, neck, everything. We're going to be hitting every single joint. This requires no equipment. This requires no special amounts of room or anything. I'm going to do it in under 6 feet. So, we're going to start with wrist rotators. So we're just literally going to be pushing it back the other direction just to get those joints moving, little tiny, almost like it looks like a figure eight, but you'll do 10 that way and then you start going back the other direction to get those wrists all ready, all the muscles, all the fibers, and then bring your elbows up to shoulder level. I'm gonna start doing some elbow rotations. We're gonna do about 10 of those, go back the other direction to make sure that we're getting every muscle group. Now this next one's one of my favorite ones. This is a shoulder rotation. So this warms up the rotator cuff. What I always tell people, get your thumbs, put your hands flat, and then push the thumbs in opposite directions. Oh man, I love that stretch. It's so crazy because it corkscrews your rotator cuff, your lats, your delts, everything. And it just corkscrews them all. And by stretching more, you're actually releasing fibers that have adhered to your bones. This will allow them for better ranges of motion and for more muscle recruitment. So now for the neck, we're just gonna put our hands on our hips and down and up. Now this next movement, what I'm going to be doing is doing it from the side so that you can see. I'm just going to be doing arm start up way above your head and you go all the way down and touch your toes and then you kind of flex back a little bit, okay? So we're just trying to get all those lower back and hip and glute and everything awake and firing.
Many minutes later.
Now next we're gonna be moving on to the hips. And no, I don't mean like the hips, you know. I'm not saying that. Don't do that. No, but what we're gonna be doing is literally just going side to side. Make your legs a little wider and you're just gonna be pushing side to side, one side at a time. Now for this next movement, you want to put your feet together, bend your knees, hands above the knees, and we're going to make little circles with the knees. This does one of two things. It helps get your knees, and it helps get your ankles. Go the other direction. I used to do this in my old karate days. Gosh, that was like 20 years ago now. Now, the next movement, what we're going to be doing is opening up those hip flexors. So what you're going to want to do is get down, go for a little wider. We're going to get down into a wider squat. Now you want to make sure that you're keeping your hands up so that your back is staying good and straight. And I want you to just kind of move the knees back and forth. Again, this is working the ankles, but it's also making sure those hip flexors are staying nice, wide open. And that's it. That's it. That is a full warm-up, hitting every single joint with no equipment, no special amounts of movement, nothing. Now you're ready for a workout. Go get them.